Hello and welcome to my recording session where I present patterns in Java. So, who am I? My name is Alexander, I'm a freelancer from Germany. Here you have my contact information, what kind of services I do provide for my clients, software development, creating automatic unit tests, doing some requirements engineering for my clients, advising companies and helping other people to find permanent jobs in German companies. So you have my contact information as in previous slide, and if you're interested, just contact me and I hope I can help you. So basically today I want to speak about another pattern, which is interpreter design pattern and how it works. First of all, let's think about the goal of the interpreter design pattern. So basically interpreter help you to have some layer in your Java application which can actually read another programming language or language which should be interpreted by the Java. I would say so. So here you see the example. I have expression, repetition, sequence, variable, command, and how it looks in the UML. I think this is wrong. It's right. Okay, it's right one. So I have an interface from which I have all of the expressions which have contract with the expression. And there you go, each of the expression must have an implementation of the expression. Then I have class which just call the stuff and provide the output. Let's go to the code. The code itself available on the GitHub, and I should mention the idea I got from the Head First Design Patterns book. The example I took from the tutorials point, and let's look in the code. So first of all, I show you my test. Here I creating my expressions classes, then instantiating it, and here you have an example how it actually looks. So let me first show you my classes and expression. As I said earlier, it's an interface and all expression must implement the interpret method, and then you have things like that that I get some context and I need to have evaluation on the given context. I'm instantiating this class with expressions. The same goes to OR expression. So OR expression have OR operator. Then I have terminal expression. And here I have something different. Here I just need to check if some stuff contains that I'm passing, so it evaluated true if and only if the string contains a specified sequence of the values. And basically this pattern must be used if you have additional language which is loaded into Java application, and Java application which you have written must do some work to interpret what it got. Basically, maybe it can be used for the games when you use in Java and you have kind of game script, and game script probably would be loaded by the Java application and then executed accordingly. And this pattern help you to create such additional layer. Well, let me. So basically, in the test, I'm checking if I can create the terminal expression object or expression object and expression object. And when I execute this test, here you see John is male true, Julie is married woman true. But what actually happening? So my test is has evaluation methods. Does what I got is a man, and it is evaluated here. I'm creating OR expression, providing first name, last name, and then the same goes to the get married woman expression. So here I have my AND expression. And then I go get the output. But the basic idea, you have grammar, which is in form of the text, or you get a message and you need to get this message. Maybe, probably it will be better than when I use whiteboard. So let's think about how it will work. Basically, you have grammar here. It can be pretty different, and then it loaded to the interpreter class. And here interpreter have some rules how to interpret what he got from the words, and then it produces the output. So basically it will be the output out. But what is the benefit when you use such system? The book itself says following about interpreter benefit. You use for each of the grammar rule a class, which easy to implement. Because that you use classes, it is easy to change or extend the language which you use in your grammar. So, and if you add additional methods, you change the behavior of the interpretation. And possible disadvantages. Actually, you should think about how complex your abstract language is. It can be quite hairy to get through the interpreted language. So behind the interpretation, you would probably have very pretty complex system in Java, built in Java. And advantages, it can be used for the scripting programming languages. But you should think about if your grammar rules pretty large, then it should probably will be pretty complex, so that you will not be able to refactor it easily. So writing tests is beneficent. And let's think about, I mean, what is my impression of the design interpreter design pattern? Does it have any practical value for the industry, for the IT industry in the world, in Java? Yeah, for some points, if you think, I think about game, if you have your scripting language written for your game, and you have a Java game, because, I mean, why not? Then it can be pretty easy to have it implemented in such a way. I think about the performance, because you have Java, have virtual machine, and then you have another layer, which is your interpreted language. So think about having a small case. If you design a big grammar language where you need, I don't know, 100 classes to express yourself in your language, and then put it through the Java, I don't think that is will be pretty performant, because then you have way too much layers. One layer is Java gets your data, it analyze your data, work on your data, and then assign memory for each of the rule which you need to use for understanding your language, interpreting your language, and then you have pretty big performance hit, because each time when you change your interpreter language, it need be translated into the Java. Java probably will, if it done it correctly, maybe it will be performant, but I highly doubt it that it can be done in the first iteration or in the many other iterations. But basically what I'm saying, if your grammar language pretty small, 5 classes, 10 classes at max, and then it probably would make sense to have such a pattern. But if you have your grammar language which must be interpreted like, I don't know, 50 or 100 classes, I would say this is not perfect case for such pattern, because maybe you should have done it, I don't know, pretty differently. Maybe you need to have a additional binary translator, so that you have, I mean, you need to think about Java virtual machine. I'm not so big specialist at Java virtual machine itself. I'm more concerned about the language, not about the machine itself. But I think if you can have your grammar language somehow translated into the Java binary bytecode, so you don't have on, like, you load your script, then some interpreter producing a Java binary code, bytecode, basically bytecode, and only then it loaded in virtual machine. Probably this will be the best way, because you would not need any additional steps to have to translate it. I mean, the translation itself costs you memory, but I will prefer to have a script which does not change, and it can be probably from point of the game development. If you have a game where you have game designer which is not skillful in Java programming language, it will be basically good idea to have such thing, so that he can write his in this highly proprietary language. Sorry, I'm bubbling through. But then, if you got it through, you create your bytecode, and bytecode executed as a separate Java application, basically. So I think my last impression of this design pattern, if you use common sense, you would not have big architecture behind your special grammar, because in this pattern you need to have for each of your grammar rule a class. So in this case, which I represented on the board, expression, sequence, repetition, variable, commands, this is the four classes for the grammar, and then they are loaded to the interpreter, and then interpreter got from some point of time get the script, and then it reads the script and put it through all of the rules of the grammar, and then some sort of a result are produced. So use it with caution. This is my last attempt advice. And that's it for this interpreter design pattern. Thank you, and until next time.